Dressmaker Sandra Celli is helping 18-year-old Romani bride Alyssa turn her wedding dreams into reality. Oh. Alyssa's thrilled with her fairy tale wedding dress and eagerly awaits the transformation of her Romanichel bridesmaids.
Ready?
Yep, we're ready.
Awesome. Okay, you want to come out?
Yep.
Okay, ta-da.
Oh my God, I love it.
I think we look pretty hot. Yeah, I think we all look hot together.
And nothing accessorizes a sizzling gypsy wedding gown more than a supersized bust.
Boobs every time.
Oh, I like boobs.
You know, most girls at 18 would be shopping for their prom dress. Alyssa's here shopping for her wedding dress. You know, they couldn't wait to get more bra cups.
What do you want, doubles, triples?
I need triple, quadruple.
I think it's because they're just so young, they're practically still developing here. But that's okay, we can make them look like women.
Try putting these in too, so we'll see if we can get more.
I won't take a break.
All right, I'm getting you boobs. I'm getting you boobs, girls.
With everything perfectly in place, Alyssa's dream wedding is coming together.
This is picture perfect.
Yep.
But something is wrong with this picture. Romani girls rarely leave the house without their mothers, and not having her mum and son present to see her dream dress is starting to hit home.
I'm just thankful that you guys came with me, because I don't know what I would do if I didn't have anybody.
She did tell me that her mother doesn't want to be around to see all of this, and I felt really bad because I've never really had a fitting for a bride ever that the mother wasn't there.
I love my dress. I feel like a princess in it. But I really wish my mom could have came to see my dress like put for the first time. And I would have loved to share that moment with my mom, but she doesn't want nothing to do with it.
She would have said, oh, my Alyssa, you're looking so beautiful. You'd start crying, and she'd start crying. And it would have been just like a perfect moment just for you and your mom.
Back home in Martinsburg, Keith needs to cover the cost of his huge wedding. Since his release from prison, he's been working in the family business as a paver, but he's now looking to venture out on his own.
How many miles do you say it got on it?
This actually has 200,000 miles on it, just turned.
Like many gypsy men, Heath's trade is tarmacking driveways, but it'll be tough to make a living without transportation.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Enjoy your new truck.
I'm definitely gonna enjoy it.
With keys in hand, Heath can now start his own business. He's pleased to get his life back on track.
I feel like a new man with my new truck. I feel like a reformed criminal. The old Heath was a wild, reckless kind of guy. If you didn't like me, you didn't like me. He loved to fight, and he loved the party.
With his future looking bright, Heath plans to put his old ways behind him, and he's determined to support his young family in the traditional gypsy way.
I'm sorry to bother you. Dad's got me out here checking with a couple of neighbors about doing the driveway work, the seal coating.
Hey, how you doing, ma'am?
Finding work at the highest rate relies on a slick sales pitch, which the Romanis call the gypsy gift. Just hours after buying his truck, the sweet-talking groom is already hard at work, bringing in extra cash.
Let's go straight to the wedding.
But in the gypsy world, life never runs smoothly. Back home, Heath's mom is furious with her future daughter-in-law.
And she couldn't stand to be around me? And I thought I was being good to that little girl.
Nettie suspects that Alyssa has been spreading rumors about her and decides to throw the young couple out of her house.
I had found out that Alyssa had been going over to my daughter-in-law and talking about how many men I've had. I could count on one hand how many men I've had.
And in Romani culture, the last thing you want to do is disrespect your future mother-in-law.
That child to go run her mouth about me. She didn't have to cook, she didn't have to clean, she didn't even have to make her own bed. And that wasn't good enough for her. I thought Alyssa was a really, you know, really good girl. You know, nobody could have ever told me any different. But now I see that Alyssa is a hateful child, the devil in disguise. Only thing I can think of is jealousy burns her alive. Crater face.
I think you've done the right thing, Nanny.
I have been around Romneys everywhere, from here, from one side of this United States to another, and I have never, ever seen so bad of a troublemaker than that little girl. She's a liar, manipulator, conniving, evil. She is not safe to be around, and I'm not going to the wedding.
Oh, I'm going just to, as soon as the man says, do you object? I'm gonna say, yes, I do, and I'm running down there and beating the out of her.
With both their families now against them and nowhere to go, the couple are forced to move into a motel.
Everybody's turning on us, and I don't know what to do about it. I don't know if it's because they now don't want us together or they just don't like my wife.
I never would have thought, like, days before my wedding, I'd be staying the night in a hotel, like, alone and with no one, like, there to support us.
But Heath is determined not to let their feuding families break up their relationship. After weeks of planning and battling disapproving parents, Gypsy girl Alyssa is finally about to marry her Romani man, Keith.
Do I get walked down now?
No.
But her dream wedding is far from how she imagined it.
The whole thing's underneath my butt cheek. Diamond!
Go, go!
And the fairy tale castle where she hoped to get married has been replaced by the local county courthouse.
He's excited.
Oh my God, he's so, he
was
tucking out
people
today.
Wow. He's nervous. He probably didn't think I was gonna go through with it.
And even though her father isn't there to give her away, Alyssa has come up with a plan B.
Do a chin, Pookie.
Get in the dress.
Get in. It's not gonna hurt her. It's just get in.
Now with just her closest cousins there to witness the event.
I can do it. I think I can.
Oh God.
This is the moment Alyssa, like all other gypsy girls in America, has been dreaming about ever since she was a little girl. Friends congratulate the newlyweds, but not everyone is happy.
Can somebody else do this?
One family member is so upset with Melly's behavior that she's had to leave.
If she comes out here or comes over here and looks at me, I swear to God, I'm gonna kill her.
You know what? I need a cigarette because I'm
too. I don't think Alyssa knew yet, but Melly was running her mouth saying that she was going to stretch her out.
Is she talking to Diamond?
Melly comes walking down the stairs behind me, talking to herself, saying, I can't stand fake ass people. Well, you got it.
Nobody came here for
Hey, Nucky and Pookie. Nucky, Pookie.
I haven't made my mouth. Get out. You better get out right now. I don't care. Why did you say you were going to stretch her out?
Of course, she's saying they're running her mouth.
Convinced that Melly was only at the wedding to fight her cousin Alyssa, Diamond decided to take matters into her own hands.
Everybody knows she won. I mean, I got the best out of her.
I want to hit somebody.
She's got the marks on her.
When I pushed Melly against the bricks, I hope I broke every bone in her body.
Oh, is that the sluts?
Oh, I don't know.
There's your slutty.
Like, when I'm mad, I go for the kill.
I ain't nothing but a damn fighter.
If she said that she had a reputation, she don't got none now.
You know, I really don't know who won. I know that she's busted up more than me, so I say I won. Her face is all messed up. It was pouring in blood.
I mean, if Melly wants the round two, she can have it. I'll be staying like a champ, like Mike Tyson.
She thinks that she needs to defend her cousin, Alyssa. Which, what did Diamond get? It's not even half of what Alyssa's gonna get.
Y'all gotta leave. Y'all
listen, you
leave.
I'm not with them.
With Melly and Diamond fighting openly in public, the police are soon on the scene.
I don't know what to do.
Hey, Muskers is being called, dummy.
Surrounded by Muskers, the gypsy wedding party makes a quick getaway.
Get in the truck.
I'm getting the
Get in the seat. That's a fight. You don't jump in.
Get out of Diamond, my
Diamond,
you handle
the truck. Go.
Come over here.
Should I call Diamond and check on her?